See if this works. Drop the old camera in the top pocket. Lots of, I just spotted a t-shirt on one lady, Chiang Mai Nanny, and there's quite a few, obviously Thai or maybe Myanmar nannies looking after Western children. I think some of the younger ones, I just spoke to one lady who was married to a Singaporean, her little boy was off school, but her older boy was still at school. And I think there's a 4-day holiday starting tomorrow. Not that it makes a lot of difference. People are still got their restaurants and places open. Got a few might close, but not many. I remember the first time I ever came to Chiang Mai, I think I was in this park the following day. It's nice. A lot of these flower beds on the left are left over from the flower festival back in February. They haven't rushed to clear them for some reason. Spotted some pretty big fish. Some, I would say 2 feet, maybe even a yard long, a metre. Not as many as there used to be. But I think they've got a better type of fish. They're more like koi carp, they're not, but they look it. Whereas before they were just grey. Not that they didn't get followed by some of the park works. I remember seeing one day. Look around, whack the netting, grab one, put it in a carrier bag and threw it in the bin. Obviously on the table that night. Nice little play area down here for the kids. All the mums have disappeared now. Real muggy, hot day today. This park sponsored by the Lions Club. Lions International. Close to being foremost here, she's just slide down those slides when she was a little girl. I remember watching them build this trio. Nice place to sit, enjoy the scenery. Look upstairs. It's been too busy for now, so there's nobody up here, so I'll have a quick wander up. Oh, sorry. Part of the old city wall. That direction to the airport. Bird's eye view. The moat. How about that? Free electric anywhere. Charge your phone anywhere you like. Nice older Toyota pickup there. Very tidy. Couple of old deers enjoying their lunch. I used to come here nearly every day, have a wander around in the morning. Coolest place to be. As soon as the coffee shop's open, get in there, have a coffee. And this is only the third time I've been down this visit. You always meet somebody to talk to. I mean, that lady from Singapore. She just said hello in perfect English, and I said, oh hi, are you Thai? She said, yeah. I said, you speak English? She said, not very well. I thought, you do. Husband's Singaporean. But you could tell she'd learned English in Singapore. She had that accent. It wasn't the normal. You know, when a Thai learns English, they tend to pick up the accent of whoever they learn it off. I noticed that with the girls the other day. They both spoke with different accents because their teachers were different. Both English, but from different parts of the UK. She said, oh, I'm looking for somebody to teach my son English. I said, you don't want me, not with my terrible accent. I said, I don't speak got that English. She said, you do. I said, honestly, I don't. What a gorgeous tropical scene. All the palm trees, the heat. I've enjoyed the heat 100%, but I haven't been too bothered, or as bothered as much as I thought I might be with it. I think another couple of months and you sort of get used to it. I remember my first day in Singapore, when I lived there in 66. Oh, I walked up the road and I thought, I'm never going to survive. Within a few months, you don't even think about it. I think that's a Thai Jaron Manapech, 51 to 2001. Blimey, he didn't last long, poor bloke. It doesn't actually say what he's obviously a singer, but what sort of music, I don't know. That's the main entrance there. I mean, all that bamboo around that archway is left over from the flower festival, as are all these flower beds. And these here are hydrangeas. They were blooming the last time I came down. But they're colourful when they come out. That clock's in honour of the late Rahman 9. That scene there from the flower festival reminds me of Kitzbühel in Austria. It's obviously a European Alp type area. And these ferns here, just like you get in the Forest of Dean. I've got some of these in my garden, I think. Yeah, Honorary Clock Tower. Built to commemorate His Royal Highness the King's 84th birthday. That's Rahman 9, not the present king. The one who died about, what, 4 or 5 years back now? Great loss. Did a lot for Thailand, that man. I didn't have my camera, it was in the back of my motorbike, but I was watching a bunch of guys playing, I've got the name, I'll tell you in a minute, because I was selling the balls around here. It's like a bamboo ball about the size of one of the ones we use to play Skittles back in the UK. And I think I'm not sure whether you're allowed to use your hand. You have to use, like, punch it or kick it over a net. A bit like badminton, but with no bats. It's called Takraw. And you can buy a ball there for 300 baht. If it's been cheap, I'd have bought one. So I remember having one as a kid, because I used to play it. And I was more energetic, a lot more energetic. Good fun it was. Yeah, what's it, badminton? Volleyball, I suppose you'd relate it to. It's just an Asian version, or volleyball's a version of the Asian Takraw. But some of the antics that the top players get up to, wow. Somersaults a lot. This part of the water here, I remember when they drained this a few years ago, and the mud and silt they took out. These little ones are feeding the fish. Oh, I meant to buy one. Oh, wow.